Look, it's a lot of money. What, 100 million for one of these supercomputers? And I'm interested as to what Abu Dhabi is going to be using it for.
Well, first, you know, today we announced a strategic partnership with G42, and the first deliverable from that strategic partnership was one of the largest AI supercomputers in the world. And as you and your audience knows, there's a yawning demand right now for AI compute. And this demand is not just domestic in the U.S., we're seeing it globally. And by working together with G42, we think we can build a constellation, not just one, but nine AI supercomputers, and fundamentally change the global inventory of compute.
Okay, because many might, rightly or wrongly, have really put all their eggs in the NVIDIA basket, feeling that is where we're going to be satiated in terms of our compute power and necessity. Are you saying that's not true, or at least we don't need to just focus on some of these large, big tech American players?
I think that's exactly right. I think first, all your eggs in one basket has historically been a poor strategy. I think dependence is anywhere in your supply chain is probably not the right strategy. But there are visionary companies like G42 around the globe. We're seeing models, both foundation and closed source and open source in Europe, coming from the Middle East, coming from Abu Dhabi, coming from Singapore. From Japan, from South Korea. And this is a phenomenon that extends well beyond the six or seven U.S. hyperscalers, yes. Right? This is a need for compute that we thought a partnership with G42 could help meet a global demand.
Can you push us into the future a little bit? We were talking with Cathy Wood about closed source, open source, and you over at Cerebras are basically helping train GPT models and then putting them into the open source community. Why are you doing that? What do you think ultimately the AI landscape looks like in 5 years or so?
Look, I think one of the things she spoke about in her session was just how fast the AI community is moving. And it's been moving that quickly in part because of the open source and not just open source, but open publishing. Mentality. People have put ideas into the space again and again, and within weeks or months, those ideas are built on, they're improved, they're furthered. And this has produced a sort of a Cambrian explosion of ideas. And we have been leaders in putting large models into the open source community. Our partner G42, through its companies, has been pushing open source models into the community. And many others have. We're not alone at all. Other hardware makers, other software makers. I think the community, the ecosystem is more healthy if it's not just a small number of compute providers and a small number of model makers.
What about the China-US divide, though?
It's an important divide. And, you know, we have to think carefully. There are no easy answers about powerful technology and the right way to manage their distribution around the world. I think it's an extraordinarily challenging problem and one that the politicians have to work through.
Meanwhile, though, the politicians have to balance the risks with the rewards. Many would say key rewards being the application of AI in science and healthcare and the like. Which industries have you been most impressed with the way in which they've adopted and used AI, particularly using your supercomputer?
That's exactly right. I think the regulation has to balance the drive for innovation and how startups like ourselves and large partners of startups like G42 can drive innovation. I mean, just recently, we've seen through our partnership with G42 use of AI models in healthcare. We have partners who do drug design with AI models. We see digital assistants helping the elderly. We see in nearly every realm of life and how we live or work or play, there's a role for AI. And, you know, you're showing some of our customers, AstraZeneca, Total, Bayer, Jasper, all using AI in profoundly different ways, I think, and G42 will use it in still different ways, too. I think they're underrepresented languages. Arabic is one of them, where there's an opportunity for tremendous expansion in the role of AI. But I think we have to work together. I think your point about export is real and a challenge. But the community has come together in the past. We've built standards together. Competitors have come together and said, this is the standard. We can overcome geopolitical challenges as well.